How's it going, everyone? It's Javi from Weather SpongeBob 1000, and in this video, we're gonna forecast the coldest temperature you should see this winter in each area of the United States, where some areas could potentially see record-breaking cold this winter. So let's first take a look at the climate division plot comparing the strong to and moderate El Nino years to the long-term average between 1991 and 2020. I have been showing you guys this in my previous winter season videos, and as you can clearly see, what we typically see during moderate to strong El Nino is that it's a lot colder than average, and it's more focused in right around the southern United States. So of course you're more likely to experience your coldest temperature to be to be at least below average compared to what you'd typically expect. So you should expect very cold temperatures, and your coldest temperature should be much colder than what you'd see in prior years where winters were at least closer to average or a little bit warmer in a lot of these areas, thanks to a strong to moderate El Nino that's expected to build. Right around the northern United States, we do see the temperature anomalies are a little bit closer to average, and typically during in El Nino, it's warmer than average right around the northwestern portion of the United States, as well as the northern portion of the United States. So I do believe the temperature, your coldest temperature, will be closer to average, potentially slightly above average this winter. But for a lot of these areas, including the East Coast, including the Southeast and the Southwest, your coldest temperature should be much colder than what you typically see during any given winter. Another big pattern that will help determine how cold the temperature should get in your specific location is the North Atlantic Oscillation. Typically during a negative North Atlantic Oscillation, we see a weak low, a weak ridge, a weak jet stream, which means that the cold air is less likely to be trapped and more likely to move further southward in the United States, which typically brings those major Arctic blasts throughout the eastern half of the United States that bring the record-breaking cold temperatures. And during a positive phase, the opposite happens. And when we see a winter where the North Atlantic Oscillation is primarily in the positive phase, and we don't see temperatures that cold and not that many Arctic blasts that would bring the record-breaking cold in your specific location, at least along the eastern portion of the United States. Like I said in my previous video, a very similar pattern is a Pacific North American Oscillation, and to make a long story short, during a positive phase, the West is warmer and drier while the eastern half is colder, and during a negative phase, we see the opposite where the western half is colder and the eastern half is warmer thanks to a strong ridge. So this will play a big role in determining if the temperatures will be extremely cold this winter, a lot colder than what you're typically used to. So first, taking a look at the North Atlantic Oscillation, we clearly see that we're likely going to stay in the negative phase for quite some time, especially as we approach January, which is very concerning if you don't want to see the cold, especially during the month of January, because if we're going to see a negative North Atlantic Oscillation peak in the negative phase right around January, the coldest month, then we should expect very intense and just very cold Arctic blasts to dominate the eastern half of the United States. You, of course, need to take this with a grain of salt. The North Atlantic Oscillation is known to, at least the forecast is known to vary within any given day or week. So we could see the forecast change up until we approach the January timeframe. We're going to need to wait and see. But as of right now, it seems like all indications are showing that we're more likely during the peak winter months going to be in negative phase. During December, it's closer to the neutral phase, so it could go either way regarding how cold the temperatures should get, or at least how cold your coldest temperature of the winter will be. But the fact that we're going to be in the negative phase during the peak winter months of January and even into early February gives me the idea that the eastern half of the United States will likely experience almost record-breaking cold this winter. The PNA pattern also points towards the eastern half of the United States to experience much colder than average conditions, which of course should allow more Arctic blasts to move through for the opportunity of your coldest temperature during the winter time frame to be record breaking, as we do see we're expected to stay in a positive phase throughout the majority of December. There could be that small period in early January where we fall into the negative phase. We're going to need to see if that keeps up before it bounces back to a positive phase and an even stronger positive phase, which would promote stronger northerly flow over the eastern half for temperatures to be much colder. And thanks to this, as well as the fact that during a strong to moderate El Nino, we see much colder than average temperatures throughout the eastern half of the United States as well as the southeast, I do expect that there should be very cold temperatures associated with some of these Arctic blasts. So you should expect temperatures well below zero in many areas of the northeast, and hovering close to the single digits in portions of the southeast this winter, which could be record breaking for many areas. So this is what typically happens during an El Nino pattern. So we see that it's typically a lot warmer right on the northwestern portion of the United States, which is the reason why I don't expect the coldest temperature to be close to record-breaking this winter. Of course, take it with a grain of salt, because even if we're in an El Nino, there could still be that 1 week or that one day where the jet stream dip manages to become an anomaly and shift against what typically happens during an El Nino. So you still could see your coldest temperature be colder than average this winter, but it's less likely in the northwestern portion of the United States. And moving a little bit further eastward, what's interesting to look at is that during an El Nino, the jet stream moves a little bit further southward, closer to the northeast, and combining that with the fact that we're going to be in a positive PNA pattern, I do expect the jet stream to dip a lot further southward, and it's typically also colder than average in the southeast, so the coldest temperature should be colder than what you experience in a lot of these areas. Another thing that's good to take a look at is a snow extent map, and as you can see, we already have snowfall accumulation in the northern portions of the United States, and if we were to see the snowfall departure from average, we are in a positive anomaly right now, where we're seeing more snowfall accumulation over the northern United States, and this could play a big role in terms of how cold temperatures should get this winter, because the more snow is on the ground, the less the surface is able to absorb the short-wave radiation from the sun, which means that temperatures are typically colder when we see more snowfall accumulation. And based on how it's looking right now, we're already to an early start where we are seeing snowfall accumulation in the northern United States and in the southern Canadian region far earlier than what you typically expect. So I do believe this will contribute to the temperatures being colder than average, at least for the eastern half of the United States, which should help the coldest temperature be potentially close to record breaking and below what you typically see. And for the snow to move this far south in the first place, it definitely had a pattern that promoted a lot more jet stream dips and a lot more cold to move further southward. So if we were to see that into the winter, which I do believe will be the case, it will certainly raise the possibility of much colder temperatures throughout the eastern half. So here's a snowfall accumulation anomaly map for El Nino years, and we clearly see that the northwestern portion of the United States experiences less snow than average, while areas just to the west of the east of the Rocky Mountains, extending into New Mexico, and a large portion of the southeast and even the northeast in general experiences slightly above average snowfall accumulation during El Nino winter. So in a lot of these areas into the northeast, the southeast, and even the southwest, I do expect that your coldest temperature will be colder than what you'd expect this winter. So make sure to be prepared for that and keep this in mind as well. Snowfall accumulation plays a big role in terms of the temperatures you're going to experience. Like I showed you in my previous video, another good thing to take a look at when determining if we're going to see warmer or colder than average conditions is a drought monitor, and typically during a drought, it's warmer than average since there's less moisture on the surface that's able to absorb the shortwave radiation from the sun and pretty much break it down through the process of latent heat, which definitely helps cool down the area thanks to the fact that it's thanks to the fact that there's a lot of water on the surface. But during a drought, that doesn't happen as there isn't a lot of water, which means that the surface will absorb all the heat energy from the sun, which means that temperatures rise a lot more quickly. And as you can see, much of the southeast is currently under a drought. So as the Mississippi River Valley and even extending into the Northwest Pacific, eventually I do expect the drought conditions to subside right around the southern United States thanks to an El Nino. But for the northern portions of the Midwest as well as the Pacific Northwest, I think this drought will only get worse thanks to an El Nino, which I believe will help limit the possibility of the coldest temperature being that cold this winter compared to what you're used to. So I don't expect as much Arctic blast this winter in those areas thanks to that. Another good thing to take a look at is the sea surface temperature anomalies just off the United States coast, because of course, if you live along the coast, the ocean plays a major role in terms of the type of temperatures you experience. It's the reason why the coast, the Pacific coast, never really gets too cold, because the Pacific Ocean, while the Pacific Ocean is relatively cold most of the year, it isn't cold enough to at least manipulate the temperature to get low enough for snowfall to occur right up along the coast. And based on the sea surf temperatures right now, we do see just off the Pacific coast, sea surf temperatures are much warmer than average. So a lot of these coastal cities should most likely experience slightly warmer than average conditions, which I believe will limit the possibility that temperatures should get too cold this winter. That could easily change within the next few months, depending on how many storms move through. But if this were to continue, coastal cities like San Francisco, Los Angeles, even extending into Seattle and San Diego, it should likely be a little bit warmer this winter, thanks to the fact that the Pacific is a little bit warmer than average. And taking a look at the East Coast, it's very variable. We do have pockets where it's cooler. The sea surf temperatures are cooler than average, whilst other pockets are warmer than average. So it's still too early to say for certain how the sea surf temperatures are going to look like. But based on the fact that the ocean has been much warmer than average over the past several years, I do believe that up along the coast, it will be a little bit harder for the coldest temperature to be close to record breaking if the Atlantic sticks with the pattern of bringing warmer ocean temperatures. So we're definitely going to need to pay close attention to that over the next few weeks. So in the United States, this is typically the coldest temperature you experience in any given winter. And in the coldest areas such as northern Minnesota and portions of North Dakota and Montana, the coldest temperatures you typically experience hover between negative 30 and negative 40. Of course, this isn't including wind chill, which typically makes it the temperature feel a lot colder. So it gets very cold in these areas. And then negative 20 to negative 30 just south of that, and so on and so forth for the southeast. So I did base my map off of this average where in some areas I did put the coldest temperature to be a little bit colder than what you experience, such as the northeast and the southeast, thanks to the fact that it likely will be a colder winter, while in other areas like the Pacific Northwest, you should see your coldest temperature be a little bit warmer than what you'd expect. So of course, in my map, there are definitely some major changes when it comes to the coldest temperature you should see. So definitely keep that in mind as I'm going over this map. So these are some of the coldest temperatures you should see this winter throughout the entirety of the United States. So taking a look at the northern Midwest, you should expect your coldest temperature to be below negative 30, which is extremely cold. Make sure to, of course, take the right precautions when it does happen, as it's over an average area, as I do expect the temperature to be either slightly above average or close to the average right in between northern Minnesota and North Dakota. Dakota. However, regardless, it should still be very cold, negative 30 as your coldest temperature. Negative 20 and negative 30 just to the south of it. I did put this area a little bit smaller, thanks to the fact that I do believe the western portions of Montana will be a bit warmer this winter, so we're going to see less of those intense Arctic blasts that will bring the temperature as low as the negative 20s. And then just south of that, I did list an area of negative 10 to negative 20. The area is a little bit less extensive, right around the Rocky Mountains, thanks to the fact that it's going to be a warmer winter. So the coldest temperature shouldn't be as cold this winter for these areas, which may be good news for some. But still, negative 10, temperatures in negative teens are still very impactful. This includes bigger cities like Minneapolis, as well as Milwaukee, extending into Des Moines as well, and just north of the Denver, Colorado area. So make sure to be prepared for temperature, your coldest temperature to be in the negative teens this winter. Just south of that, I did list an area where you could experience temperatures anywhere between 0 to negative 10. So in the single digits, but in the negative range. This includes bigger cities like Boston, New York City, even extending into Cleveland, Indianapolis, Chicago. Your coldest temperature should hover around the negative single digits, which is in a lot of areas a lot colder than what you experience, especially right around New York City metropolitan area and the southern coast of New England. So you definitely want to prepare for that. And then moving just south of that, I did list an area where your coldest temperature should hover around the single digits, but in the positive phase. This includes Philadelphia, Washington, D.C., just to the west of Charlotte, and extending into Little Rock, Arkansas, and Oklahoma City. These areas, your coldest temperature should hover around the single digits. Just south of that, it should hover around the teens in the positive phase, of course. This includes bigger cities like Raleigh, extending into Myrtle Beach, Atlanta, Birmingham, Alabama, and even extending into Dallas, and potentially just north of San Antonio as well. Your coldest temperature should hover around the teens, which is very cold, and make sure to prepare accordingly for that. Just to the south of that, you should expect temperatures to hover around the 20s, just below freezing, at least for your coldest temperature. This includes New Orleans, Jacksonville, Florida. This includes Houston as well. Phoenix is involved, as well as Seattle and Oregon. So the coldest temperature shouldn't be that cold in a lot of these areas, as along the Pacific. It's mainly due to the fact that the Pacific will help warm up the temperatures right up along the coast of the West Coast. And of course, the latitude helps as well. Jacksonville and Houston aren't very far north to experience temperatures that cold, but you still should prepare for the possibility of below freezing temperatures. And in the areas where you should expect your coldest temperature to still hover above freezing, this includes Central and Southern Florida, cities like Orlando and Miami, Southern Texas, and even portions of California, where along Los Angeles, San Francisco, San Diego, your temperatures shouldn't fall below the freezing mark this winter. So this is my coldest temperature forecast for the entirety of the United States. If you want even more in detail forecasts regarding the coldest temperature you should expect, then make sure to comment down below, and I'll give you guys a more in detail forecast regarding the coldest temperature you should expect. But in along the southeast, it is colder than what you'd expect, so make sure to prepare for that. But that's it for now, guys, and I thank you guys for watching.